Exciting for a lot of people, but unfortunately for other people as well, their favorites had to bow out at the most crucial point. Yeah. Savannah Region's Haria and Greater Accra Region's Nah. But I must applaud you, ladies.
Thank you.
Listen, thank you. I was thank telling you even before we came on air that coming this far means a lot. And so you've done so well.
Thank you.
I know you weren't expecting this. Tell me how yesterday went. What were you supposed to do to justify your inclusion in the top, what, six?
Top five.
Top five. Yes, what were you supposed to do yesterday?
So you're supposed to give them enough reason why you should be part of the finalist, and that was just the task. Surprisingly, during my rehearsal, it went very well, but, you know, getting on stage, you know, we got on stage and then went back in and coming back again. When we went back, I think I was telling someone that I was nervous. It hasn't happened. And I was really disorganized in thoughts. My head was burning.
Why?
Yeah, I have no idea what was happening to me on stage even before we performed. So it's like I saw it coming.
You could sense that.
Yeah. Yeah, I was really disorganized in thoughts, and then my head was burning. It was really not a good feeling.
Did you also not think that just maybe your people would have voted enough? And so even if you still felt the nerves on stage, you would have still been pushed by your people?
No, yesterday was clear evidence. I just had a chance to just justify my inclusion, so I wouldn't say it's on the vote. I would not say it's on the vote because they always assure me to not to even worry about the vote because they will do their best. Yeah. So I should just keep doing what I'm doing, just like I do always, especially on Sundays.
I see.
But just yesterday, maybe was not my time.
Exactly.
And just like our theme song, True Ghanaian Woman, you're wise and strong. Rise up and tell your story. So I have a story to tell.
Indeed.
And I believe everything happens for a reason. So yesterday probably was supposed to be.
Probably.
But I'm sorry to my...
You don't... No, you don't have to apologize. I'm sorry, but we'll not take any apology. You did your best.
Yeah.
And of course, God knows why.
Exactly.
Your journey may have ended in this competition.
Exactly.
But he probably has a bigger plan for you.
Exactly.
So it doesn't matter. Yeah. I'm sure they appreciate you anyway.
I love you too.
Haria, what about you? I mean, how did yesterday go?
Okay, I would say yesterday my first performance didn't go well with me because I was surprised I was being the first person to answer because I didn't know I was the first person to answer. So it was like, all of a sudden Anita mentioned my name, Haria starts. So I was confused. So it made me disorganized.
Yeah.
Because, and I remember during my rehearsals, everything went all well. And even the producer said, we have a show. So I was so excited. Someone would say super excited because I thought I was going to have a show tonight. Talking about my second performance, it is something that, it is my story. So I decided to put myself in it and I later on became emotional because even during my rehearsal, when I was rehearsing, I started tearing. And Ezekiel asked me why. I'm like, my own script too, and I'm crying because I know what I've been through. And then I'll say I'm so proud of myself. If no one will say they are proud of me, I am proud of myself because I'll say I am competing with people with so much experience. I just completed SHS and I just entered university my first semester, and taking this bold step to come and compete with more experienced people. In fact, Haria, you've done well.
You have.
And talking about, one may think maybe it's because of votes. I don't think it's because of votes. If you're talking about votes, my people did massively well. I was second on the chart. So I don't know.
You were second on the chart for the votes.
Yeah. So I don't know what happened. Maybe it's not my time. And I say thank you to God Almighty for keeping me this far. I'm fine.
You're fine?
I'm fine.
I mean, what's the plan? You say that you have a story
and,
of course, you have a plan ahead.
Yes.
So even without GMB, you can still make that plan
come
into fruition.
Exactly.
Tell us about that.
You know, before I come to the... I came in incomplete. But now I am very complete because I've learned and I've experienced and I now acquire emotional intelligence, soft skills, which are emotional intelligence, empathy, expertise and exposure. And I believe these skills are very expensive to me, which I'll hold in high esteem. And I'm ever ready to impart younger generation out there, young ladies especially, to become better version of themselves. And also, being a victim of a broken home, I've developed a passion to help eradicate streetism by putting them into schools and finding trade or vocation for them. And I cannot do this alone. So together with NGOs and other stakeholders, we can achieve this cause. And yeah, we couldn't go to the finals, but definitely I would ensure that this cause will be maintained.
What's been your highlight in this competition? Which of the weeks was your favorite, your best performance ever?
Fortunately, every performance was my favorite. I put myself in. Apart from, I think, first week and second week. But afterwards, because I took all the critiques from the judges into good consideration, positively, to work on myself. And I came back stronger and have been just going harder until yesterday happened, which I'll say that I'm very proud of myself. I appreciate myself so much. And still, God knows best. What is more important right now is being able to take up the mantle and fulfill my goal.
Definitely. What about you? What has been your highlight so far?
Bella, I'll say every week has been my best week because every week I come out stronger. As I said initially, I didn't even believe I would do this. So coming on stage to perform well, I think every week has been the best for me, and I'm grateful.
What's your project moving forward?
Okay, growing up, I realized most women and girl child in my region do not have proper education. So anytime I'm back from school, it's like you're from heaven. Because there's this, when you attend school, proper school, you realize things will change on you, your walkings, your talking and everything. So whenever I get home, people will be looking at me in a different manner, as if I just came back from Dubai. Then I realized it because they don't have the same quality education and proper education. So I thought of it, what can I do to help these people? Because you realize that most of my mates back in primary are getting married. Some are even pregnant. You see most of them on the street selling water. So I was like, wow, why can't they also have this education I'm having? So I thought of it, what can I do to help these people? That is why I embarked on this empowering platform to help. And I know I'm not going to leave them. I am going to support them. I'm going to do my best possible to support these young ladies. I know they need me. They need my support. And I'm coming to help them.
Who's winning? Who's winning? Who's winning?
Who is winning?
Yes.
Okay.
Who do you think is likely to win?
Is likely to win? I would say Isidwa and Honam, because I see and they have the qualities of a queen. Okay. I always saw them in the house that being a queen is not just the looks, you know. It's what is inside of you. It's what is in your mind.
Exactly.
So I see, queenly qualities.
Yeah.
Yeah. In them, Isidwa and Honam. So
Aria, what do you,
I'm praying
what
for them.
Okay.
Bella, funny enough, ever since we came to Ghana's Most Beautiful in the house, I don't have a favorite. As in somebody I've born with, I don't have one because I'm trying to be neutral. I want to be okay with each and everyone. So I don't have a best friend, so I can't pinpoint this person.
You don't have to be best friends with a person. Before you see that they are very capable of something.
But
you know?
I see everyone capable of winning the crown.
Okay.
Everything can. Who thought I would go home? But here I am.
Yeah.
So everyone can win. Anyone can win.
And all the best
all
to them, right?
Yeah, all the
We're
best
We're going to dance
them.
At this point because we need to end on a high note. What's going to be your favorite song so we play it, then you can boogie to it? What song do you like?
My favorite, as always, Sheer Jolly Jolly.
Okay,
Sina Soul.
Are you okay with that as well?
Bella, any song you play for me, I'll
You'll dance. Okay, well, she says any song, Shubuga. Let's see if we can get Sina Soul's Jolly, and we can boogie and end this, you know, on a good note. But ladies, you've done amazing.
I want to thank some people so much.
Go ahead.
I want to use this opportunity to say a very big thank you to each and everyone who supported me. My uncles, family members from other regions, my mom and dad. Somebody told me that, Haria, you have the best mom and dad in this world. And I'm grateful. I love them so much. I love the whole of Bupe. Hey, this love they showed me is too much, because no representative has had this much love and support. To my chief, lawyer Nashiru, each and everyone supporting me, and my managers, Uncle Lati, everyone who supported me, God bless you. And I won't forget this favor. Thank you so much. I love you all.
How are you now?
I would take this platform to thank every individual that supported the dream, that prayed for me and supported in kind. I'm very grateful. And to my mom and my dad, my family in general, thank you so much to Tina Ahima and to His Royal Majesty Dolobosu Adamte. Thank you so much to all the chiefs and sub-chiefs. I'm highly grateful. I'm so grateful to the regional minister and everyone. Like, the love is amazing.